The English We Speak
from bbclearningenglish.com.
Welcome to The English We Speak. I'm Feifei.
And hello, I'm Rob. Hey, Feifei, listen to this.
OK, interesting. Has your ready meal finished cooking in the microwave?
Yes, actually, but I wanted you to name that sound.
It's a ping sound, obvs. So, what's that got to do with today's piece of authentic English?
Well, we can use the word ping to describe something else.
I know that, Rob. Ping is a short, sharp sound, like a microwave makes, to alert you that the food in it is cooked. But the word ping is also an informal way of describing sending an email or a text message. So, if I ping you an email, I basically send you an email.
Exactly. And, oh, someone's pinged me a text message. It says, let's have some examples, Rob.
That was me, Rob. Come on, then.
I need to know the details of the contract. Could you ping them over to me as soon as possible, please?
My friend's just pinged me to say she can't go out tonight. So I suppose I'll have to stay in and watch TV.
I'll ping you over the address of the party and hopefully I'll see you there later.
This is The English We Speak from the BBC and we're finding out about the word ping, which is an informal way to describe sending an email or a text message. And Rob, I'm going to ping you something.
Oh yes, what's that?
I'm going to ping you an email containing a recipe.
A recipe? What would I need that for?
You need to start cooking some real food. You can't live on unhealthy microwave dinners.
Oh, right. And I'm pinging you a message right now. Send.
If you'd invited me for dinner, I wouldn't have to eat microwave dinners. Okay, Rob, I get the hint. How about tonight?
Great, but can you remind me where you live?
I'll ping you my address. See ya.
Don't forget. Bye.
The English We Speak
from the BBC.